we present John Moffatt as Hercule Poirot and Stephanie Cole as Ariadne Oliver in Agatha Christie's Hallowe'en Party.
Hallowe'en Party? I thought that sort of thing only happened in America.
Goodness, no. You lead such a sheltered life, Ariadne. Haven't you seen all the witches' hats in the shops? Anyway, I promised Rowena Drake that I'd lend a hand, and I did kind of hint that you might be going.
I hope you didn't make any rash promises on my behalf, Judith. I don't want to find myself presenting the prize for the best pumpkin.
I didn't promise anything. Well, she knows your books, of course.
So many people do.
I thought it might provide you with a story.
Mummy, I'm sure my temperature's gone down. There's nothing wrong with me at all. I'm sure she'll be fine by this evening. Can't I go?
Half an hour ago it was 102. You can't have recovered just like that. Back to bed, Miranda.
But everyone else will be going.
Well, they'll just have to do without you. Off you go. Mrs. Holt will bring you a cup of tea. Come on, Ariadne. I promised Mrs. Drake we'd be there by 3.
And I'm not expected to do anything?
Nothing at all. Just think of it as the background for one of your murder stories.
I'm so glad you were able to come, Mrs. Oliver. And it was so good of you to agree to judge the girls' fancy dress competition. They'll be so thrilled.
Fancy dress? But I understood that I wasn't going
to
be asked...
Where are you going to have the snapdragon, Mrs. Drake?
In the dining room.
I'd best get something to cover up the table, then.
There's a green baize cloth in the cupboard in the kitchen.
I thought we'd hang those fairy lights all the way around the landing, Mrs. Drake. Will that be all right?
You're not going to hammer any nails in?
Oh, no, we'll just tie them up.
Yes. Is there anything I can do to help?
Gracious no, Mrs. Oliver. Why don't you find
Where's
a chair?
Where's the lobbing for apples going to be?
In the library. Mrs. Minden's gone off to find a really solid bucket, one that won't fall over. This is Ariadne Oliver, Miss Whittaker.
How do you do?
Miss Whittaker teaches at the Elms. That's the school most of the girls go to.
How do you do? You know, I've never understood what apple bobbing had to do with Hallowe'en. It doesn't seem appropriate somehow.
Apples were supposed to be associated with happy souls. You were given an apple to keep the evil spirits away.
Evil spirits?
Hallowe'en was the night when the force of evil was at its most powerful, when witches were free to consort with the devil. And in this part of the world, they used to hold a Sabbath at the old stone circle at Kilterbury Ring.
For on Hallowe'en Eve, the night I shall ride, and all our ninefold sweeping on by our side.
Are you going to tell the girls' fortunes this year, Mrs. Goodbody?
Well, I don't do the telling exactly. I give them a mirror, and they see the face of the man they're going to marry.
Oh, that's what that ingenious contraption is that Nick is rigging up. It's to project pictures onto the mirrors.
Are you the lady that writes the detective books?
Yes, that's right.
I read one of them once, The Dying Goldfish. I thought it was quite good.
Thank you, dear.
I thought it was a bit tame, really. Only one murder.
One murder is generally quite enough for most people.
I saw a murder once.
Don't be silly, Joyce.
Did you really? Did you really and truly see a murder?
Of course she didn't, Anne. Don't say silly things, Joyce.
I did see a murder. I did.
Murder will out. That's what they say.
What kind of murder? Why didn't you go to the police?
Because I didn't know it was a murder when I saw it. It really wasn't until a long time afterwards that I began to see it was a murder. Something that somebody said only a month or two ago suddenly made me think. Of course, it was a murder.
And when did you see this, my dear?
Years ago. I was quite young at the time.
I don't believe it. You're making it up.
Of course she's making it up. She's always making things up.
I'm not making it up, Leopold. I swear it.
That's quite enough, Joyce. Why don't you tell us about it, then?
I brought the apples, Mrs. Drake. Where do you want them?
In the library, please, Mrs. Minden.
Right.
Just a minute. I can never resist an apple. They're my besetting sin.
And they help to keep the evil spirits at bay.
Mmm, delicious.
I'd better go and see where the boys are going to hang the pumpkins.
It's pumpkin night tonight. It's pumpkin night tonight. Give us a candle. Give us a light. It's pumpkin night tonight.
It's pumpkin night tonight. It's pumpkin night tonight. Give us a candle. Give us a light. It's pumpkin night tonight.
Hercule Poirot speaks.
Oh, thank goodness for that. I felt sure you'd be bound to be out.
No, my dear Ariadne, I am having a quiet evening all by myself.
Look, I'm in a terrible state.
Yes, I can hear that. What is the matter?
It's too difficult to tell you on the phone. Can I come round and see you straight away? You're the only person who might know what to do.
Now, come and sit yourself down.
Oh.
May I get you something to drink? A little cognac?
I don't drink. Surely you haven't forgotten.
No, I have not forgotten, but I thought it might do you good.
No, I don't want anything, really.
Then calm yourself. And tell me what it is that has upset you.
Well, it all began with a party, a Hallowe'en party. Do you know what that is?
I know what Hallowe'en is. The last night in October, when the witches ride on their broomsticks.
There was a witch. She was called Mrs. Goodbody, but I don't remember a broomstick. It all started with the apples.
Apples?
Bobbing for apples. It's one of the things you do at a Hallowe'en party.
Ah, yes, I think I have heard of that.
The party ended with a snapdragon.
Snapdragon?
You know, burning raisins in a dish.
Mm-hmm.
I suppose that must have been when it happened.
When what happened?
The murder. Everyone went home after the snapdragon, and that was when they couldn't find her.
Find whom?
A girl called Joyce. Everyone went round the house calling for her. We found her in the end, in the library. That's where they'd been bobbing for apples.
What had happened?
You know, I think I might take a little brandy after all, just a little.
I mean, of course.
Someone had shoved her head down and held her there until she drowned in a galvanized iron bucket full of water. It was horrible. Not at all like the way murder happens in my books. I never want to see an apple again.
Here. It will do you good.
Oh, thank you. Oh.
Now, when did all this happen? And where?
Last night, at a place called Woodleigh Common.
Woodleigh Common. Now, why does that name seem familiar to me?
I was staying with a friend, Judith Butler. She's a widow. I went on an Hellenic cruise last year, and she was there too. We got to know one another, and she asked me to come and stay at her house. And I was invited to this Hallowe'en party. It was for young teenagers, really. Sort of celebration for the girls who had passed their 11 plus.
Did any of the people who were there know who you were?
Oh, yes. One of the children said something about my writing books, and they started talking about murder. And that's what led up to the thing that made me come to you.
And what is that?
Joyce said, I saw a murder once. And somebody said, don't be so silly. And one of the girls said she was making it up. But she insisted she'd seen it.
Had she told anyone about it? Her parents? Did she go to the police?
No, the other girl asked her that, and she said, because I didn't know at the time it was a murder.
A very interesting reason. And do you yourself think that she really had seen a murder?
It's the only way that her death makes sense. That there was a murder, and that she was a witness to it.
But that would mean, would it not, that the murder was committed by one of the people at the party?
Yes, but it wasn't at the party that she said it. It was in the afternoon, when everyone was getting it ready. You don't think I'm just imagining things, do you? What other reason could there have been?
A girl was murdered by someone who had strength enough to hold her head down in a bucket of water. An ugly murder. And a murder that was committed with no time to lose. Somebody thought they were threatened and struck as soon as it was humanly possible.
Joyce could not have known.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.